Diagnosis currently for rheumatoid arthritis is done with blood testing, which is only about 80% accurate, and physical examination and history. The problem with rheumatoid arthritis is that there is no best approach for determining the optimal treatment. There are certain features that might give us weak hints about, well, maybe this drug over that one, but there's no hard and fast rule, which is why we're hoping synovial biopsy will come into more widespread use. When a patient volunteers for our research to undergo synovial biopsy, we bring them in separate from their regular office visit to our ultrasound suite. We numb the area over the joint that's in question, and then we enter that joint with a needle under ultrasound guidance so that we can see where we're going, avoid things that we don't want to insult, and get a piece of that thickened synovium, that thickened joint lining, which is the target organ, the place where the disease is happening in rheumatoid arthritis. We make a number of passes, we take out maybe 2 or 3 grains of rice worth of material, and that goes to the lab for analysis in our research. The recovery process from a synovial biopsy is very simple. The patient comes out of the procedure with just an ordinary Band-Aid, no stitches. They go home the same day. We even let them drive themselves if they feel comfortable doing so. And they really just need to leave that bandage on for about 24 hours, and then we call them back to make sure they're doing all right. Right now, the types of patients we're studying in rheumatoid arthritis using synovial biopsy are those who are at a decision point in their treatment, which is exactly where we'd wish this would help us. So patients who come to us for the first time and are on no treatment. Patients who have been on the traditional first treatment, methotrexate, and it's not working. Or patients who have been on traditional second-line treatment, TNF inhibition, and it's not working. Those are the 3 steps in rheumatoid arthritis treatment where we're grabbing those patients and asking them if they want to be part of the research so that hopefully we can learn at those important inflection points, what does that tissue look like? When we're doing an ultrasound on an arthritis patient, the main question we're trying to answer diagnostically is this wear and tear or is this inflammatory? So we're looking for 3 things: thickening of the joint lining, production of excess fluid, and hyperemia, excess blood flow in that tissue. One of the most exciting things I think about synovial biopsy is that despite what you might think when you hear the name, patients tolerate it very, very well. Over 90% of our patients will actually agree to get the biopsy done a second time, and that really kind of tells you how well they're tolerated. Right now, synovial biopsy is only being done under a research approval, but we are hoping to bring this into clinical practice. One of the reasons Northwestern Medicine is a good place to come for arthritis care is that once we get this off the ground, we should be able to offer this clinically to patients, and there are very few places in the country doing this. The hope is that we're going to be able to diagnose a lot more patients a lot more specifically and a lot sooner using this technology once it's ready for clinical implementation.